JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for July the 29th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but one of the other major currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian morning Thursday. It lost the most ground versus CAD, CHF and GBP in that order, while it was found virtually unchanged against the Japanese yen. Now, the weakening of the US dollar and the Japanese yen, combined with the fact that the main gainer was the risk-linked loonie, suggests that the financial world traded in a risk-on manner yesterday and today in Asia. The only variable that does not fit the equation is the depreciation of the Swiss franc, otherwise called a safe haven. In any case, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that major EU indices traded in the green, and although Wall Street's Dow Jones and S&P 500 failed to gain, Nasdaq edged 0.70% up, with market sentiment improving further during the Asian session today. Yesterday, ahead of the FOMC decision, European shares traded higher, perhaps due to encouraging earnings reports, which may have helped investors look past worries about the tightening regulations in China. Nonetheless, investors in the US did not join the party, perhaps due to the Fed's relatively hawkish statement. The committee kept its policy unchanged, but although they repeated that they will keep the pace of their quantitative easing purchases unchanged until substantial further progress has been made towards their goals, they added that the economy has made such progress and that they will continue to assess the progress in coming meetings. Investors may have translated this into willingness to start withdrawing support sooner than previously assumed, and that's why they slightly reduced their risk exposure. Having said all that, though, at the press conference following the decision, Fed Chief Powell said that the labor market has still a long way to go and that inflation is still expected to fall back to longer-run goals. He also added that the timing of taper will depend on incoming data and that they will provide advance notice before any changes. This put cold water to expectations of an early tightening, which may have been the reason why the dollar fell and equities rebounded during the Asian session. The next FOMC gathering is not scheduled until late September, and taking into account that we did not get any advance notice yesterday, the earliest policymakers could start scaling back quantitative easing is in November or December. And all this conditional upon further notable strength in the labor market. As for our view, with Powell refraining from fueling tapering expectations, the dollar may stay under selling interest for a while more, while equities could keep drifting north, also aided by encouraging earnings. The employment reports are now likely to be of more importance than previously, as possible setbacks could push expectations over a potential tapering into next year. Rate hike expectations could also be pushed back, although they have not changed much after yesterday's outcome. Still, investors anticipate the first 25 basis points increase to happen around March or April 2023. Now, as for today's events, today we get Germany's preliminary inflation data for July, with both the CPI and the HICP year-over-year rates expected to have surged to 3.3% and 2.9% year-over-year from 2.3 and 2.1% respectively. This is likely to raise bets that Eurozone's headline inflation print due out tomorrow may also accelerate notably. The first estimate of the US GDP for the second quarter is also coming out, and the forecast points to a rising growth rate to 8.5% quarter over quarter from 6.4%. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.